Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we continue with the series OCR. I will be talking today about Azure AI Services Computer Vision and how to do OCR in using Azure Services. So let's move to the Azure Cloud. For those that they are familiar with Azure, this probably is repetitive, so you can jump up this section. But for those that first time that are not really familiar with Azure's AI services, continue watching this, and then later on we will go to the demonstration of how to do OCR. This is the you need to a Microsoft account to access the portal, the Microsoft Azure portal. And then once you have your Microsoft account, you need to create a subscription. And then if you are you are new at Azure, you will get some credits that you can spend in whatever you want. In Azure, it's not you just use either one of the subscription or the subscription you have, or create a new one. Inside the subscription, I recommend you to open if you want to mix or you want to reuse one of the resource groups you have, use it. It's not create a new one. It's pretty simple. Just create inside the subscription and be just aware of the region where you are going to create the resource group. It's not a problem for this test, but if you are going to interact with other services that you are that they are already running in Azure, like data lake services or Azure ML or whatever you had, be conscious that where you installing which region, because first of all, not all the services are available, all the functionalities, I mean, of the Azure AI are available in all the regions, and it may vary depending where you set up, the location where you set up. I'm setting up this in UK South. All the services are fully available in the States, but here in UK some of the latest functionalities of Azure services, AI services, are not available. In any case, for what I'm going to show you, we had this as well in my region. I created a new one, and then inside the resource group I create a Azure AI service multi-account service. To do that, you just click create. You will go to the marketplace, and in the search box, you just write Azure AI service, click on that, create, and use the subscription, the resource group, the region, the name, and the pricing tier. If you are new, you will have available the free layer, this one. The fee F0 is not like in my case, you only had access to the standard services, and you need to pay. But in any case, yeah, the cost is pretty for this test is inexpensive, and again, if you are new, you had 5,000 transactions per month free and 20 transactions per minute. The difference in between the free service and the standard one, obviously, is the number of transactions per minute, and also the number of transactions per minute, the number of transactions, free transactions per month. So for this test, it's clear that you can essentially use the F0, especially if you are new to and you still have the credit that are available when you create an account in Azure Cloud. Once you have this created, you just click on that. It's going pretty quickly. So for those that are familiar with Azure, this interface before was Cognitive Services. It was renamed, regrouped. Now it's slightly different. I had some examples of 6 months ago. I need to rebuild them all of them practically today to create this video, because before everything was included in Vision, and then now they transition part practically all the documentation, document treatment, document OCR, document scanning, and much more to the Document Intelligence Service, which I will show you as well in this video. And here Vision is only for image right now. I recommend you, when you if you try to do this in your computer locally, depending as well when you are going to do it and when you watch this video, to review the documentation, because again this is something for the I'm using this probably for the last 3 years, and then it has been a big change last 3 years, and still evolving, including new features, reorganizing the services. As you see here, they had language, speech to text, vision, now document intelligence with this completely new. This doesn't exist 1 year ago. And then again, I recommend you to read the documentation before implement something, even a POC, because it may change for what I'm going to show you here on the video. So let's start with video Vision. So Vision, you had multiple models as well: face recognition, customer classifiers, OCR. Well, again, we are going to use OCR, but you can go to the documentation, read which models you have available. You can even personalize your model for your own purpose. And well, it's now, I will say, mature service. It's working for several years, but continuously evolving. So it's worth it to spend some time before you start to code, in read at least what is available, what is not available in your region, and how to use it, because it's not you may lose some time and just understanding how it works, and only even just to replicate what I'm going to show you, because again this is changing, and as you will see in the document intelligence interface, I will not show you the latest one because it's in beta and it's something that is not available even in the computer document intelligence studio. And yeah, I prefer not to show you, not to mix up everything in this video, and just show you what is a devolution of what I tried 6 months ago. You watch my videos in the channel. I did some other videos about the OCR using TCR, because I had some specific requirements to run the models in on-premise, and then I don't have access to a service like this, because usually I don't have connection to internet, and then I need to develop my models in a Docker container without internet connection, and had all the installation connected in local, no, or available in local without internet connection. In your case, if you had access, there is not a requirement for your business case. This is something that you may have available, but when I started my project 6 months ago, the interface was slightly different to that today. Some of the services are not available now in Vision, in Computer Vision, and are available in the Document Intelligence. So again, I recommend you to read the interface and read the documentation before start to code. If you go to the Vision Studio, you can start testing either the API. You can use this either with code or with code which it can be C#, JavaScript, or Python. Also, you can use the API, the REST API that is available with your endpoint. And in your endpoint, I will show you this. I forgot how to access the service. And also you can use this studio just to do some kind of testing before start to do any further test. You can also use a they offer Docker's container completely ready to go. Just download the image and run it. It's pretty easy to use it with the latest models. Everything is run very, very, very easy, very straightforward. And what's more, to access the service, once you have installed it, you need to copy the key, at least the key and the endpoint that is deployed just for your use, and the key. This is one of these two keys you can use it just to access the service, which is authenticated. And again, here I just make a try, a test with a document, with an image, and well, you will see now on the test in the Jupyter notebook that, well, at least this will help you to try very easily with different images and see what is the format of the response, how it looks like the service, and how you can start to use it and understanding what are the possibilities of the service. And I recommend you to enter first of all here to the Vision Studio and do at least some tries before to start coding, which is not what you will see at the end later on the notebook is gonna be very, very similar, but here is just you drag and drop the image and you get the response in JSON file. You can take a look at to the text that it was extracted. If you see the image is very, very good quality, it detecting even the dots, which I had some issues with Tesseract with the default setting, and this is really, really working. It gives you a lot of information. You receive a response is a class, a Python class, data class in our case if you are using Python, and this can be transformed to JSON, a dictionary obviously that has some principal keys and every principal key, well, metadata and then on the information organized in lines and inside every line the words recognizes. So as you may know, the images are scanned from left to right and from up to down. When you read an image, this coordinates in the left top corner is the 0, 0, and the documents always so the information that you will receive here, in this case in DPI, sorry, is always making with reference to this corner, to the top left corner. So here you see the line 0. You will see later on in the example better. You have the text senior Python developer, which is the first line, and the bounding polygon is doing a reference. This is the first. Also, how they make the bounding boxes. So you will show. They are these coordinates is first of all the top left vertex, then on the top right vertex, top right, bottom right, and bottom left vertex. So this is these four coordinates of these four dots in the of this rectangle, and this is how they organize the information on the JSON file. This bounding polygon, these four vertices are those points I explained you before. Then on there is another key for per line with where they are doing exactly the same but word by word. So if you see here senior, they take the word senior and they show you the bounding box of this word, no? This is exactly this bounding box, and the coordinates they are following exactly the same approach, no? Top left, top right, bottom left, and also In the per word, they are also giving you a confidence score, which in some cases are really, really useful, because, for example, this document doesn't have any quality problem, but in other cases you will see that there is quality issues because there is, for example, an stamp in top of the doc in some where with this overwriting part of the test, and you will see that this confidence score is lower because the model is unable to recognize the test behind the stamp, no? So in some cases you can simply establish a threshold and say everything that is below some confidence, don't use it, or allow the user to clarify what is going, what is behind, or simply just show the scores, and then the user can also take a decision themselves what to do with that information. So this is the Visual Studio. I will show you now on code. So again, this before was Cognitive Services. They still had some reference to the Cognitive Services, but probably when you access to the video or try to replicate it, maybe even they change. Again, for me, I had some other, as you will see here, I had some notebooks that which I prepared 4 months ago. It's nothing. It's, I told you that I didn't use this long ago, and then what I have here today, I was unable to reproduce with the latest model available in my region. And then I was using exactly the same, the same service is still in my subscription. And today, when I tried to use these four notebooks, it didn't work. I need to rebuild all these notebooks just to create this video. But okay, it's fine. Again, that's why I recommend you, when you try to do it, just before go and read the documentation and see something changing, like in my case. To use the computer vision, not only OCR, everything that is included on the service, you need to install this library, Azure AI Vision Image Analysis. And once you have installed it, I have installed this in a cold environment with Python 11. And well, you just import what you need, this layer from the libraries. Now, again, this change, before was Cognitive Services, I don't remember, it's in the other notebooks. So you can see here, you use the image analysis client, visual features I will show you now, and the Azure key credential, that is to access, using the endpoint and the key, you need to authenticate it versus the cloud in order to use the endpoint. Everything is served through the endpoint, which is attached to your subscription, and if you don't provide, obviously, the endpoint and a valid key, you will not be able to access the service. This is how all these Azure or Amazon or Google services works, so nothing new here. I use a lot dot end to with a dot end file to with my credentials. That's well, it's just security best practice. And then you create your image analysis clients with your endpoint and the Azure key credential object. I just here put the name of the file I'm going to analyze. I will not show you because it's later on using computer vision, Open Computer Vision and Matplotlib. I will show you some examples of this the same document. I just make a help here of the image or visual feature. This is new. This was not some months ago when I used the service. And then on there is different features in computer vision service. There is multiple models, one to do captions, detect object, detect people, read is the OCR, there is tagging as well. And to be honest, I didn't read what is smart crops and dense captions. This is completely new for me. I will take a look and then later when I have some time to see what new are in these two services. But well, we need to use the read features, and then on it's pretty simple to use as before. You just open the file in binary format. You create and using the analyze method of the image analyze client, you just send to the endpoint the binary data, and you just inform the endpoint which model you want to use, and in our case is read. And then once the here we are not controlling if there is any error, just simply send it, and we will receive a result. Is a class. I will explain you now this object. And well, I just simply here printing what Azure is returning to me, no? As you can see, you will see later on, and then when you use your own example, you will see that the quality is quite good, no? So you receive an object with this as image analysis result object, and then you can transform this object to a dictionary, and the dictionary I save it here to JSON. Well, that's for further use. And then on the main three main keys of the or groups of the dictionary returned from Azure is model version, metadata, and real result. Model version is the version of the model obviously use it. This is quite new. It's just 3 4 months ago. Metadata, here we are just receiving weight and height. Before we were receiving some additional information. I will not mix up now with what information we received before. Today we just received the width and height in DPI. And read result, that is the biggest block where you contain all the extracted content from this image. So if you go to the section lines, you receive all the information split in lines, and you will see here that we had also blocks. Blocks is sections. For example, if you had a document with two columns, you will see this more clearly later when you see the document analysis, document intelligence interface. But here, well, practically in an image, unless that you are extracting information from a document where you have clearly identified sections where there is a lot of space in between these blocks, it will create, like in this case, a single block. Also, another case that you will receive for sure different more than one block is the case that you have two columns in the document. So not the document that you may scan, for example, translation documents. They used to write the document in two columns, with one in one language and the other one the translation in another language. In these scenarios, if you take a picture and you extract the text from that picture, you will receive the information in two blocks. That's why I recommend you to use the studio before, with different cases of the typical documents that you are going to use with the interface, and see how it looks like the response that the service is returning to you. So here in my case, I just get a block. All the information is contained in a single block, and I will show you now what is included in one line. If you remember what you saw in the studio, it's exactly the same. It's nothing new, but it's only just want to show you that you will get the same information using the Python SDK. Again, you can use as well C# and also JavaScript. The results are exactly the same. If you are more comfortable coding in those other languages, you will receive the same. Okay? And then per line, here I'm just extracting the information on the line 0. You will see that you have the text, even the dot. You watched the video before I did about Tesseract. You may remember that they had some issues with the dots, these bullet points. They didn't recognize very well. And again, here, as explained before, you had the polygon, the bounding polygon. This is the coordinates around this text, the line. And then you had the section words, where you had the different words in this line, and the bounding box around these individual words, together with the confidence score. I here create some helpers, some lists with dictionaries to later on plot the bounding boxes in top of the image, just to show you how which quality is provided in the service is quite well. Then it's just in this case I'm just taking the as I explained before, the information in this of these coordinates, and taking all the x and all the y's and putting in a list, and then on extracting the minimum, maximum, x and y, just to later on create a rectangle. You need these coordinates to create the rectangle, and this is what I'm doing essentially here. Creating a new dictionary with the text and the y minimum, y maximum, x minimum, and x maximum to later on plot this. No? So you see here an example of the new list I created is the text again with all the x, all the y's, and the mean x and min x, min max x, y min and y max. I just create for here some other libraries to do the plotting, and you will see now on the screen. I create here just a function to plot the image using OpenCV. I will not enter into the use of OpenCV. Maybe later we can do also other videos. This is not the purpose of this video. We read the image and we just plot it, no? With a title here. And as you see here, probably we had here, this is the last line recognized. Take a look. This is general exposure and familiarity with machine learning technologies. General exposure with familiarity. So you can see here even there is a small defect in quality, the scanning is had the kind of the angle, and it's recognizing anyway very well the text. I can show you some examples if you are interested in what happened when you had an image with these problems and how to correct it. But again, this had to be included in other videos. Not this is going to be very, very extensive, very, very long. Here is just creating the contours. Contours is the technique that usually you use to detect the text on an image. It's just in few words, this fine contours in OpenCV is just detecting when the image had a variation on the density. So here is detecting when, for example, it's changing the edge in the image, where there is a transition, for example, here from black to white, and then on is detecting this contour. And then what we are doing with this piece of code here is just writing the contour of this parts of the image where there is this variance, this change of density, and to detect this change of density. This is how it's based the OCR. We are detecting these changes on the image where they change the changing the color, and then you are able to write a contour. Then on this contour is what you later on pass to a model, usually a sequence-to-sequence model, LSTN, or recurrent neural network, to translate this contour to a letter or to a word. Okay, this is the only one to show you how is working. Is the initial step, if you want to say that, to do object character recognition, no? And then we just plot or draw in top of the around the letters, around the characters, these contours detected by in this case by computer vision, open computer vision, but it's exactly the same what is done in a with a neural network or a convolutional neural network. Here I'm going to plot the bounding boxes line by line and just create define some parameters for OpenCV. And just what I told you before, we just need the x minimum, x maximum, y minimum, y maximum to create the two vortex of the rectangle. You need the top right vortex and the bottom left vortex to draw a rectangle in OpenCV. Is what I'm getting here, and just transforming the numbers to integer 32, and here we just transform it to RGB. Well, just you had you need some information. Just read the documentation on OpenCV. This is a very established and well-known method in OpenCV 2. Also, here we use another method, is putText. Here is just simply here we draw the rectangle, and then here we just put the text detected from Azure into the rectangle. Here we are just depending on the of the line, we are just modifying this vortex, where it starts this vortex, because when we pass the number 10, obviously we need to write the test slightly more on the left. And then here input using the put text object, we are just again writing the text. The text is a composition of the key. The key is the number of the line with an space, and also the text detected by Azure OCR. Azure Computer Vision. And as you can see here, it's exactly the same as we have on the text. You may wonder what is these two interrogants. These two interrogants is because I don't have this key installed in this computer. When I did this test, I had another computer, and in this new, I still didn't install this this font, and that's why some characters are not correctly translated when you draw it in. Using OpenCV, and that is for images. As you see, it's really good quality. I'm using anyway this paid service. The quality in this kind of documents will not change even if you use the free tier, but in general the quality is really good. Now let's move to the Document Intelligence. Document Intelligence. So you go here. It's here. Okay. So we had Vision. This is everything related to images, and then you had now Document Intelligence. This Document Intelligence was existed months ago, but it was again not as developed like today. Also, they had read the documentation, because there is a lot of things that you can do here. So you had document analysis. So you had this interface read, that is what we are going to use to extract text from words, location, as they say here, from PDF, TIFF, GPGs, etc. In the new version, I'm using now version 3, the latest available through the Document Intelligence Studio, but in version 4 they are announcing that they will include even MS Office documents, something similar to what I did with Tesserar, not only PDFs and TIFFs, only also MS Office documents. I think there is somewhere else. I don't remember where I have it, but well, in the documentation is contained which types of documents they will accept in version 4. Again, we are not going to see this today because the version is still in beta and is not available as well here in the Document Intelligence Studio, at least on my region. Probably you are in the States. Yeah, you say this version only supported the version 4 is only West Europe, West US 2 and is US. I'm using the UK South in my case, because it's the closest to my location, and then in my region is not supported. Also important for you, first of all, review which services and in which versions are available in the region where you are located. You had the document analysis. This is more orientated to extract the information from forms with this layout. Then on the read is slightly different, but more orientated to extract text from documents like a PDF, a scanned PDF, for example, which have multiple lines. I will do an example later on with this. And then you had also pre-built models, which had multiple examples of invoices, receipt, health insurance card documents, tax documents, ID documents. Very orientated at the US market, to be honest, but well, you have the custom models that you can personalize for your documents. So you had a form that is pretty extended use on your company. You can create a custom model and use it. It's pretty simple to do it. At least I did it some months ago when I was testing this model. This interface, and well, it's pretty easy to do to create your personal, your custom model, and then it performs, it make a very good recognition. Essentially, this is, well, you train a model to recognize patterns. These patterns are a combination of the OCR extraction together with the location of this, and which is usually what happens when you have a form. No, in this form you had for example the name and the surname, the date of birth in the specific locations of the form. And then what they are doing with this custom models is just you telling to the model you have a studio. We can make a video if you are interested about that. You have a you in the studio, you just create, label all these locations, and you say the model, okay, when you see something here in this location, this is the name. That simple than that. The pre-built models are the Microsoft already did that for you, and then these are prepared to, well, you see W-2 tax form, which is obviously this is from the States. Multiple ID documents, these ID cards, also receipt, invoices. But well, I can imagine that I didn't go into details with that, but most of these examples are from American market, US market in few words. But as well, to not to be very heavy with my comments, but yeah, you can do the same, and you can train model just to identify the different types of document, which is well very simple. No, you just create a template, no, like a template with the studio, recognizing what you had included in your model, locations and text, and then it's pretty simply to do an extraction model and a classification model. If you go to the studio, you just simply, here is the same that in computer vision, you just drag and drop a document here. Upload a PDF with 8 pages, and you can see here, well, something that we commented before, the content is exactly the same. now is in these blocks, they name the blocks paragraphs, and the paragraphs are these sections. Similar, you remember what I told you before, just simply, well, if there is enough separation in between the text, it's considered like a paragraph, and then the paragraph is working exactly the same like a block or like a page, no? It's starting the section or the section to be extracted from the vortex, the top left vortex, and ending in the bottom right vortex, and the information is extracted from left to right, from top to down. This is working with the same approach, exactly the same that it should do for the page and for the line. This is completely standard in OCR. The result exactly the same is another class which later on you can transform into JSON via how to say a method that is included in the class, and here even you had code to do this in your favorite language, no? With a set again available in JavaScript, C Sharp or Python. Again, I'm using Form Recognizer, Document Analysis Client. You will see now that in version 4 this also changed, and I didn't want to mix all this information. We will just follow Form Recognizer, and then I will show you how to use in the SDK, which is pretty simple. So we just I give you here the information. The version 4.0.0 is now Document Analysis Client, is changed to Document Intelligence Client. For what I read, it didn't change too much in terms of the method to use to send the binary information to the endpoint, but well, worth it to you read when you are going to use it. Today we will cover Azure AI Form Recognizer Library, which is the latest library to work with the version 3.1. You install it with PIP. The way that we interface with the endpoint is exactly the same as computer vision. You just instantiate the class using the endpoint, passing the endpoint and passing the credential using the Azure Key Credential object. Here plot a little bit the documentation. Again, this is easy to read on the Microsoft documentation, but well, for short reference you can take a look here. And then I have here took another PDF. This is just 2 pages document. When you call the interface, well, you use the Documents Analyze Client, and you use this method with, for what I see, it didn't change in the new version, in version 4. So you just send the model. This is the simple request, use a model, and the pre-built read is using the model read to extract the text from documents, and you send the binary data, the bytes of your document to the interface. You just get the result, and you transfer the result to the dictionary. In the dictionary now comes different more kits. It's obvious. This is more similar to what I saw in my previous interaction with this library. And then you have here the pages, which is the number of pages that you had in the document. Here this is new, but in my document is empty. Paragraphs, that is these blocks I showed you before, page by page, the blocks, no? And you can see here the content, so you can get as well, it's working exactly the same. This is in the page, the polygon, which is around the paragraph, exactly the same as lines, exactly the same as words. Every page now contains, obviously you have multiple documents, the result is organized in pages, in the attribute pages is a list of the other objects. The object in this case is the object page, and every page contains different attributes as well. This is another data class in Python. Page number one now come with an angle. This again, this is what I got used to work in the previous version. This is the rotation angle of the page. In some cases, you can use this. This is clockwise rotation, so it is positive. The object is slightly rotated to the right. If you get a negative, it's rotated anti-clockwise. So, but here, if you see, this is a small degree. I told you before in one of these documents is. There is a small rotation, it's like probably a defect of the scanner, something like that, but okay. This angle is giving you page by page if there is some rotation clockwise or anti-clockwise on the image scanned, no? Here the width and the height, this time in inch, also important. When you are using this interface, you can receive inch or pixels, depending later on which application you are going to use. You will have to translate the inches to pixels. To do that is pretty simple. Now you will get the width and height in inches. This is a reference as well to the top left vertex, which is 0, 0. Here we had the maximum width is 8.5 inch, the maximum height 11 inch. If you want to transform this to DPI, you just multiply, for example, by 300. You want to get this image in 300 DPI, just multiply this by 300, and you will get the coordinates in DPI 300. Every coordinate at the same time need to be translated on the same way. This reference is in inch. If you want to get it in DPI, you just multiply by 300. If you want to use the resolution of the 300, if you want to use 64, for example, multiply by 64. Here the spans, instead to have words, we had spans. But again, the class of the object is very similar to what we get using the computer vision interface, the computer vision service. Now we have as well, this is new, the content is giving you the full content, full text of the document, all together, all the pages together. And here I'm just printing what we extract from this file, no? Line by line. I think I had the document somewhere open. If not, I will open it again. It's just this document. It's a PDF. I wanted to use another one. Again, this is just two pages for a PDF. This PDF come from that was originally a doc, was printed into PDF, and then on the interface is going to detect if the document is an scanned document or the document is a printed PDF, no? And then on depending how it's detected, here you will receive inch or pixel, and you will have to add, depending what you want to do with this information, with this metadata, you will have to transform the inch to pixels if you want to plot it, for example, with the computer vision, create the bounding boxes as I showed you before. And well, that's all. I think it's a lot. There is a lot of more things that we can do with the AI services. This is just the peak of the vortex of the iceberg. So there is a lot of things more that we can do, but well, the purpose of the video was to show you how to do OCR with the different services, and well, we can do other videos if you are interested in for other services, but for OCR with this you had something that is enough to start. You can explore a lot of more. Again, read the documentation, because this is a live service. It's changing very fast every month. I suppose they are releasing new functionalities. Since I know the service is changing a lot, and well, Again, I have nothing with Microsoft, but again, I use it since long time. It's giving very good quality, and if you had the possibility to use it for your use case, it's one of the options that you need to explore. I'm going to make videos as well from OCR Space, also from TechStrat, Amazon, our Computer Vision, Google, which I used it as well on the past, and you will be able to compare. Again, up to you, what is probably you are more familiar with other service, with other computer security cloud provider. It's up to you. I just give you my how to say my experience of using the service, and that's all, no? And okay, that's all for today. If you like the content, just please give me a like, and if you are not subscribed to the channel, it's time to do it. Thank you. See you soon.